Continue to follow breaking news on Hawaii Island. Kilauea volcano began erupting at about 4:44 this morning. Here to tell us more about what's going on and what we might be able to expect, USGS Hawaiian Volcano Observatory scientist in charge, Ken Han. Mr. Han, nice to see you again. Thanks so much for joining us.
Good morning. I look a little frightening this large on the screen there.
No, you don't. You're actually kind of like a little calm for us, because if we're talking to you, we get the information accurately, precisely, and you tell us exactly what to expect and maybe kind of what not to expect. So let's get right to it. 4:44 a.m. it started erupting. What else can you tell us?
Well, this is going to be kind of a repeat of the summit eruptions that we've had recently, starting in 2020, right? And this looks like it could be one of the larger ones. It's already, the new lava has already covered completely the floor of Halemaumau crater, and is still going strong. We expect this really high effusion rate part of the eruption to last for a day or two, and then it should kind of calm down and go back to somewhat lower effusion rates. But it's really spectacular right now. There's red lava all over the floor of the crater. We don't expect it to have any impact outside of Halemaumau crater at all. And we've been sort of waiting. The conditions on Kilauea have been pretty much prime for the eruption to restart. It's been 5 months since the last eruption began in January 5th, and it ended in mid-February, really, or early March. And the summit of Kilauea has continued to inflate. And last night, starting around 10, we started to get flurries of earthquakes, which really intensified around 3:40 this morning. And that's when we upped our alert level from yellow to orange. And then at 4:44, it was followed with lava coming up right in the middle of Halemaumau.
Now, Ken, first of all, you said the situation was prime for it to start. What do you mean by that? What made it prime?
Well, what we've seen is over the last month or so that the summit of Kilauea has continued to inflate. And so the inflation levels were higher than anything we've seen in the last 2 years or so. So it has been, we could tell that magma was being stored there. And then we were starting to get certain characteristic earthquakes, and the number of earthquakes really picked up beneath the summit as well. And so we were just sort of waiting for conditions to get to where the volcano would erupt. So we've been kind of waiting and expecting this for a couple of weeks right now.
So you have been monitoring it and watching it for weeks now, because it seemed like, whoa, this morning the warning level and the aviation levels were changed, and then all of a sudden there's activity and there's an eruption.
Yeah, we don't get much, you know, we're in a new phase of life since 2018 where we're not getting days of warning. So the same thing with all these summit eruptions and the Mauna Loa eruption, we really only get about an hour worth of real warning before the eruption takes place, to where we can say confidently there's going to be an eruption.
Now, we know that Mother Nature is unpredictable, but you don't believe that this will, I guess, exceed the crater, that it will stay within Halemaumau crater?
Yeah, I think this is just part of the sequence of events that we're seeing, refilling the old collapse, right, that happened in 2018. And we've already filled it almost 1,000 feet of the collapse crater that occurred in 2018 has been filled up with lava. And this certainly looks like it's going to continue that. We expect it to, it's going to be very visible from the viewpoints within the park. And we actually expect, if this eruption continues to go on, to get up to the next level and start flowing over the next level of downdrop blocks in the within Kilauea caldera.
Okay, and before we let you go, if people are just joining us, please let us know again how long they can expect Kilauea to erupt. And also, if you want to let them know, should they be concerned? And also, we didn't talk about air quality as well.
Yeah, and I think that is going to be the biggest concern right now, is the start of these eruptions, because lava's been stored, have a lot of lava coming out, and hence a lot of volcanic gas. We have pretty much normal trade wind conditions right now, so that means that most of this gas is going to blow to the south to the people in Pahala and Nalehu and over in Ocean View around the south end of the island. So they're probably in for a couple of days of pretty high VOG, and then VOG levels are going to return to normal. And I wish I could tell you how long the eruption will continue for. But that's one thing that it's very hard for us to predict. We're much better at looking at the onset eruptions than when they're going to end. But we would guess if it's typical of these others, it can last for several months.
All right, several months. But right now, residents not being impacted in terms of it coming anywhere close near a structure or anything.
Right. There's no threat to any infrastructure within the park, and certainly not any infrastructure, any personal property outside the park. We did, however, just get finished with that large seismic survey that we had 2,000 seismometers placed over the summit of Kilauea, and we picked up most of them within the caldera. We left some down there just to record if an eruption started. So we actually have an extra about 100 seismometers down in the caldera right now, which should be really interesting. We won't be able to look at that data for probably 6 months or a year, but we should have a lot of data on the start of this eruption.
All right, well, we'll look forward to that data, Ken Han, and we look forward to speaking with you again, hopefully in a little bit. Thank you so much for joining us so early this morning.
No problem, thank you.